Hello everybody and welcome back to another video by Blissful Techno Health. In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to use a computer using Windows 11. This is going to be lesson one or video one in a series that I'm going to create in a playlist on my channel. In this playlist, you're going to be able to find a variety of videos on the basics on how to use a computer. This video series is going to be for beginners who have never really had to use a computer much for whatever reason, and now you need to use a computer. Technology and computers are very important in our current day and age, and it's an absolute must to have a computer in order to communicate with a lot of the world or have transactions, see what's going on in the world, etc., etc. In this lesson one video, I'm just going to be showing you some basics about the computer, just getting to know some things about your computer and your desktop screen. Here you can see my mouse cursor moving around, and you can see I have a variety of different things here. You have kind of a cool looking background picture that comes with Windows 11. I've got some icons over here. I've got some icons down here on the bottom. I've got some other icons down here on the bottom right. Now for starters, an icon is basically any kind of a virtual button that you can press or click on using your mouse. Some of these icons require a double click, some of them require a single click, but we'll get into that more advanced, we'll get into that a little more detail later on. For now, we're just going to kind of cover some basics. These are the desktop icons that I have on my computer. Yours will look different. You're going to have different icons than I do, depending on what programs you have installed and what other things that you have going on, what shortcuts you've created, and etc. So don't be worried if your computer doesn't look exactly like mine. That is okay. Nobody's computer is going to look the same. So just understand that. But you're always going to have these icons over here as shortcuts to access programs on the computer. Okay, and then you'll see down here on the very bottom, we have this bar with some more icons on it. On the bottom right, you can see that we have the time and the date. We've got, this is a laptop, so it's plugged in and it's showing me the battery usage. I have my volume sound icon controller here, my wireless internet access connection here, and etc. You don't need to know a lot about these now, but just know that there's a purpose to all these icons here, and we may go over those in more detail later. Now, depending on your computer, these will also vary. Over here in the middle, you're going to find some more icons. Over here, you'll typically find icons that you use more often on a regular basis. Your file explorer, your web browsers, commonly used programs, and etc. So these are other things that are other icons just to make it easier to access programs quickly, just like these are over here on the desktop as well. Now, a couple of important things to understand is you've got two buttons here that are going to be highly utilized on your computer. You've got the search, and you've got this one to the left of it as your start menu. Okay? The search is going to be your best friend, because anytime you need to find something on your computer, you can search for it here. And not only can you search for it on your computer for like what apps you have or documents on the computer, you can also do a web search from here. Now this will direct you to use typically your Windows Edge browser, which is just fine. We can go into more detail about that later. But just understand that you have the search utility here to search. Very important, very useful. Here's your start menu, also very important and very useful. Here in the start menu, it's very customizable. You can customize different icons in here just like you can on your desktop. You can control what icons you have in here, which ones you don't want in here, just for easier access and more organization. Down here, it's going to list recommended apps, things that you've used a lot in the past, things that it thinks it wants you to use, etc., etc. Don't worry about it too much for now. This will morph and change as you use your computer. And it can make it easy to find things if you don't have anything pinned, but it's something you've used recently and don't know where you have an icon for it. We'll get into this more in more detail later on how to change these icons or unpin them, as they call it, or pin them here for icons that you want to have in here organized and how you want to use it. So for now, that's a basic rundown of your desktop screen. Your desktop has this picture that can be changed. You've got icons that can be changed. You've got your time, date, etc. okay, and these icons down here. Now, a few bits of important information, at least in my opinion, they're important because I think it's important to know about the hardware in your computer, because every computer is going to be different and your computer will have different hardware specifications than someone else's. The hardware specifications can be different things like what processor you're running in your computer, what hard drive you have, and how much storage, how much space you have available on that hard drive, how much RAM you have in your hard drive or on your computer. The RAM is an acronym for random access memory. The more RAM you have, the more desk space per se your computer has to work with. We won't go into that in a whole lot of detail right now, but for now, let's just talk about where to find those specifications. So if you come down here, you can see your start menu. If I left click on it, it brings up the normal start menu. I can also right click on this start button and it will give me a different menu. That right click gives me this menu here, which has an icon on it that we want to go to that says system. So feel free to right click on that and follow along and come up to system and left click on system. When you pull up system, this is going to give you some information about your computer. Okay, it's going to give you the device name when it was originally set up. But what we want to look at is right here, the processor and the installed random access memory or RAM. On this computer, you can see that I have an Intel i5-8250U CPU or central processing unit. This is running at 1.6 gigahertz. And this particular processor that I have is a quad core with hyperthreading. So it shows up as an 8-core. You can see here I have 8 gigs of RAM installed. Now this is important to know because some programs on your computer are going to require certain hardware specifications in order for that program to run properly. So if you're going to run a really big fancy game on a computer that doesn't have enough RAM, then you're going to have a problem. Or if the processor is not going to be powerful enough, you're also going to have a problem. The game may not run at all, or it's going to run really slow. So this is really good to know. Think of it as like the engine under the hood of a car. You're looking under the hood, trying to see what hardware specifications you have. Now, this shows us our processor and our RAM, but one other thing that's very important to know is your hard drive space. So we're gonna come up here, we're gonna click this X up here. It's just gray until you come over it and then the box turns red. So go ahead and click on that. And then you wanna come over to File Explorer. Okay, that's this manila folder down here. You want to click on that, and when you click on it, mine's set to go to videos because I'm working with videos. You want to come over to the left and click on this PC. So you get this menu open, come to the left, click on this PC. When you click on this PC, you're going to see you have different options available here, different icons. Now, under devices and drives, you'll see there's a little arrow here. I can hide that or bring it down. Local disk C. Anytime you have a C labeled drive, that is going to be the main hard drive in your computer that Windows is actually installed on. That's going to be your main storage. You can have additional hard drives installed, but you can see on mine, I have just this one hard drive. On this hard drive, you can see that it says I have 148 gigabytes free of 222 gigabytes. So this hard drive has 222 gigabytes available in total on the drive. But I've only got 148 free because I have programs and other things already installed. This bar tells you the usage in a bar mode. So instead of telling you the actual numbers, it gives you the bar mode. If I hover over it, you can see it says that information as well. When this bar gets full, you got a problem. It means you need to clear up space on your hard drive or add another hard drive and move some things around. So that is your hard drive space. This is not a very big hard drive. Hopefully you got a bigger hard drive, depending on what you're running. I don't need a big hard drive in this computer because it's a basic office computer I use in my print shop. So there you have it. Your hard drive, you also know how to find your system information for your random access memory and what processor you're running. We also did a quick rundown on the desktop, what things are on the desktop, or per se that there's icons on the desktop that can be different from icons in your start menu and from your taskbar down here. Now, just remember a few of those terms, that you have your desktop, you have icons, this down here is your taskbar, and those areas where to go to find out what hardware specifications you have. And like I said, that's important to know, because if you're going to buy a program that requires a lot, you need to make sure that your computer can run that program. I hope this first lesson video has been informational for you. And if you're a beginner at this, if you have any questions, please feel free to shoot me a comment or a question down below. Or if you have any requests on things that you would like to learn about with your Windows 11 computer, also please shoot a comment down below. Please be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on my next videos in this series. And you want to click that notification bell so you're notified when the video is uploaded, as I will be uploading them very soon. Thank you guys, and have a beautiful day.